Hello everybody, we are here at AMZS Safe Driving Center in Vransko in Slovenia, and today we're gonna present you the BuWizz ISUZU tow truck, and I will ask Jernej to explain more about all the functions that it has.
Hello, first of all, thank you for hosting us here. So this project was designed as, a showcase of the mechanical functions, because real cars and this, let's say, 1-to-10 scan model, they all share the same mechanical principles. So the idea behind this model was to make it as realistic as possible. We took their actual ISUZU truck as a reference. I did have some, liberty when it came to the design, so it's not a total replica, but the basics are the same. What we wanted to do was to make a car that is, in this case, a F4x4 tow truck that is capable of actual towing another car and also capable of going off-road and having good off-road and on-road performance. To do this, this car is motorized using four BuWizz motors and controlled by two BuWizz bricks. And we are using them to drive the four-wheel drive. It even has differential locks in the front and the rear, and it has a two-speed gearbox. When it comes to other details, it has a functioning arm, which is capable of lifting a 2-kilogram model and capable of actually towing it. We also made a custom profile in our BuWizz app. And here we can control all the functionality of the model. And let's first start with the basic. We have, of course, we have to drive it. So we can lift the hood. And currently the car is in neutral drive. And when you give it gas, you can see that even the fake V engine is spinning along with the drive motors. Second thing you need to drive is, of course, the steering. So we have a functioning steering. And also the steering wheel inside the cab is steering. Now, as I mentioned before, we have two gears. The low gear is for going off-road or when pulling cars. And the top gear, it is for, well, on-road, and is capable for this model to reach around 10 kilometers an hour. Now, when off-roading, we also have a differential locks. I can showcase them here. Now, when you go off-road, it's good to have differential locks because they allow all the wheels to be powered. And when we lock the differentials, we can see that these rings slide into the differentials, locking them. And just like the real car, which also has the differential lock, I think it has on the rear axle, but this one has it on all three differentials. So it's very capable when going off-road. Also, when off-road, of course, you need suspension. In the front, we are using independent suspension, so each wheel is independently suspended by shock absorbers. And in the rear, we are using a live axle, just like the real car again. The live axles are more robust and allow for greater articulation when going off-road. And of course, we need the extra robustness in the rear and extra hardness because it also has to support the weight of the vehicle that it's towing. And back to the towing, this model has a fully working towing mechanism. So first thing, we can lower the towing arm. Then we can lower the secondary arm. So if you imagine there's a car here, you go reverse under the car. And then we need to lock the wheels with this mechanism. So this extends. So now that the wheels are locked, so they cannot move forwards and backwards. And then we can just simply lift and pull the car. And in case we need extra pulling power, we also have a working winch. And finally, we also have lots of details. So when you open the hood, as I demonstrated before, we have a working fake engine. We have an air filter. We have a water tank for the windshield wipers. We have a battery. Inside, we have a full interior with two seats, working steering wheel. You can even open the compartment box. And finally, as with any proper towing vehicle, we have canisters here for fuel. extra parts, so spare parts. And on the other side, we have all the necessary tools that a mechanic might need to fix cars that are stuck. And under this, you see our BuWizz controllers. And this way, you can also access them and charge them. So all in all, this is one of the most functional projects I ever built. I'm really proud of it, how it turned out. It has over 3,000 pieces. It weighs over 3.5 kilograms. And I am really happy that we were able to cooperate on this project.
What is the total number of motors?
A total number of motors. So we are using 4 motors for driving. And then we need 1 motor for steering, 1 for differential lock, 1 for gearbox, and 4 for the arm. So in total, we are looking at 11 motors.
11 motors.
11 motors.
Quite a lot.
Yes.
Okay. So thank you very much for this presentation, Jernej, and thanks to AMZS that we were able to cooperate on this project, and hopefully we will do more cooperation in the future.
Thank you very much for this. This is an honor to be part of this project. For us, it's actually an honor that you are using our truck. I'm just asking when this will be joined in our fleet, because it's fully operated. So it can join other trucks in our club. Otherwise, AMZS is also proud to bring knowledge how to build such a technical difficult cars and pieces together, because in Slovenia we need a younger population to be more interested in project like this, because it's also developing the mind how to create something. That's why we are also proud to be part of this your quite big success.
This is the small BuWizz AMZS modular car. It is meant for basically for children to be able to put it together, and it's very sturdy, so it doesn't break apart. And it is made out of two parts, the chassis and the body. And also there is instructions are also made in two parts. So the idea was that two children can build it together, and one of the children can be older, a little bit more experienced, and then that child would build the chassis, and the other child, who is smaller, and would build the body. And of course, they can also cooperate and, you know, help each other.
So yeah, as Ronnie said, this was meant like an educational model. And the basic idea was that we had to make this model as simple but robust as possible, and it should not be complicated. So the model had to be optimized so that we use as little amount of different parts as possible. So use as little amount of so that children don't get confused. So just a limited selection of parts. The end model has to be strong and robust, so you can play it, you can drop it, so nothing happens to it. And it has to be easily buildable, so children can build it. That's why I separated the model, as Ronnie said, in the bodywork and the chassis. And this also allows us, because we have a separated bodywork, that we can make the bodywork in different colors, so that children can easily differentiate the models when they are driving them. So, oh, red is mine, blue is theirs, and so on. And yes, it's a very simple, light model, but it's almost indestructible, and I really like how it came out. And I really hope that also the children assembling them and playing with them will love it as much as we do.